Hi children, good morning to everyone. Okay, in your previous class already you have to learn the topic of division, right? Yes. In this class let us revise once again what is the division and how to divide in numbers. And this is a sign of division. It can be read as divided by. Yes, this is a sign of division and it can be read as divided by. And what is division? Yes, the division is a repeated subtraction. Repeated addition is multiplication. Repeated subtraction is division. And in this division, the number with which we are dividing is called divisor. What is divisor? Yes, a number with which we are dividing is called divisor. And what is dividend? Yes, the number to be divided. What is dividend? The number to be divided is called dividend. And what is quotient? The quotient is the answer. What is quotient? The quotient is the answer. The answer we get on the dividing the number is quotient. And it says how many times the number is dividing. Quotient, that is the quotient. And what is remainder? Yes, the number that remains after dividing. After dividing, we get the remaining number is remainder. We call that is a remainder. So these are the words in this division. Already you have to learn this. Divisor, dividend, quotient, and remainder. Now let us see verification. In this division, we are verify the given answer. We are the getting answer is correct or wrong. So this is the verification statement. Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. We are multiply divisor in and quotient and add to remainder. If we get dividend, yes, the answer is correct. The division process is correct. So this is the verification process in this division. So now let us see the examples. In this division is also used to, and this division is used to find out the cost of one things or objects. Cost of one object by when the cost of many bags, many things or many objects is given. For example, the cost of 10 bags. The cost of 10 bags is 1, 6, 7, 5, 0 and 0. The cost of 10 bags. 1, 6, 7, 5, 0, 0. That means 1,67,500. The cost of 10 bags. What is the cost of one bag? Now what we'll do? Yes, we will use the division. The cost of one bag is equal to, now we will use to find out the cost of one bag, we will use the division process. So let us divide this number. That means which is the cost of total bags? 1,67,500 by how many bags are there? 10 bags. So 10. Now let us divide the two numbers. It is a very easy process to dividing these numbers. Cancel 0, 0. The remaining numbers are 1,6,750. 16,750. The cost of one bag is 16,750. So this is the cost of one bag. Here we used the division to find out the cost of one bag or one object or one thing. So this is the process of division. Now let us see how to divide given number by two digit number. Let's see. write these numbers at first. So this is a divisor. 65 is a divisor. So write this divisor at left side. 65. And what is the dividend? Yes, this is a dividend. So we will write this number at middle of these two brackets. 3, 4, 5, 6, 3, 9, 2. Here we write the quotient. Let's see the process of this division. First we will write the 65 table, that is multiplications. So 65 into 1, 65, and 65 into 2, 130, 65 into 3, 195, and 65 into 4, 260, 65 into 5, that equal to 325, and 65 into 6, that equal to 390. We know already that how to multiply numbers, right? How to multiply two digit number by one digit number. So this is the multiplications. 65 into 7, that equal to 455, and 65 into 8 equal to 520, and 65 into 9, that equal to 585, 65 into 10, that equal to 650. So this is the table of this 65. Now how to divide this number? Yes, first we will take two numbers. So from left, first we will take two numbers from left side. There are 34. 34 is a smaller number than 65, right? Yes, 34 is a smaller number. So we can't divide a smaller number by the bigger number. So we will take three numbers from left side. 3, 4, 5. That is 345. So 345 is a bigger number than 65. So now we can divide this 345 by 65. Now we will see the 345 in the table of 65. Let us see 345. Where is the 345? And that is between these two numbers. 345 is between 325 and 390, right? Yes. So which number we will take? Yes, the smaller number. So now we will take 65 into 5, that equal to 325. Why we will take the only smaller number? Because this is a bigger number. Already we know that we can't subtract bigger number from the smaller number. So we will take the smaller number, 325. 65 into 5, that equal to 325. So 345 is between these two numbers. So here we will take this statement, 65 into 5, 325, because which is the smaller number. So 65 is 325. So write this product of this 65 into 5 below the 345 number, below the which is we are taking the number. So now we used subtractions. Already you have to learn what is division, repeated subtractions. Now we will subtract given number 325 from 345. 5 minus 5, 0. And 4 minus 2, yes, 2. 3 minus 3, 0. So next one, 20. So 20 is a smaller than 65, right? So now again we will take 60 below the number. We will take this number 6. 206. So now we will see where is the 206 on the table of 65. Let's see 206. And that is in the between the numbers of 195 and 206. So which number, which table we will take? Now we, which statement we will take? Yes, 206 between these two numbers. So now we will take the smaller number, that is 65 threes. 65 threes are 195. Again we are subtract this number 195 from 206 or 206. 6 minus 5 that equal to 1. So write 1 below these numbers. 1. Now 0 minus 9. We can, yes, we need to borrow one number from the 2. So there are 10. 10 minus 9, 1. And 1 minus 1, 0. So the number is 11. Now again we will take 3. So there are 113. Now we will see where is the 113 in the table of 65. 113. That is in the between these two statements. 65 into 165 and 65 into 2, 130. In these two numbers. The 113 between these two numbers. So we will take the smaller number, 65. So 65 into 1, that equal to 65. 65 ones are 65. Now let us minus these two numbers. 3 minus 5, we can't subtract. So we need to borrow one number from the tens place. So 13 minus 5, 8. There are 0. That means we need to borrow one number. There are 10. So 10 minus 6, 4. There are 48. Now again we will take this number 9. 489. Let's see where is the 489. 489 is between these two numbers, right? The 439 between the 65 sevens are 455 and 65 eights are 520. So we will take the smaller number. So 65 sevens, 455. Next, minus these two numbers. 9 minus 5, 4. And 8 minus 5, 3. And 4 minus 4, 0. 34. Now we will take 2. 342. Let's see where is the 342 on the table of 65. 342. Where is the 342? Yes, that is between these two numbers. So in these two numbers, which is the smaller number? 325 is the smaller number. So we will take this 65 fives. 65 fives are 325. Now minus these two numbers. 12 minus 5, there are 2, there is 2. 2 is smaller than 5, so we need to borrow one number from the 4. So it will becomes 12. 12 minus 5, 7. So there are 7 and there are 3 tens. So 3 minus 2, 1. And 3 minus 3, 0. So finally we get the answer is 17. Any number is left to taken below? No number is left. So 17 is a reminder. 17 is a reminder. So 17 is a smaller number than 65. Right? So this is the process of division. In this division, we are use subtraction, repeated subtraction. Here we will subtract these two numbers. Again, we are taking this number, and next we will take the other number, and finally we get the remainder is 17. And what is the quotient? Yes, 5, 3, 1, 7, 5. This is the quotient.
this is the quotient which is answer, and this is a reminder, and this is a divisor, and this is a dividend,
and 65 is a divisor, and which is divided, that is the dividend, and the answer is quotient, and reminder is the remaining number is 17. So 17 is reminder. So is this you right? Let's see verification. Let's see verification. So is this you right or wrong? We will use the verification statement. Let us see the verification.
What is the verification statement? Yes, dividend. Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. What is the divisor? 65. And what is the quotient? The answer is 5, 3, 1, 7, 5. Plus the remainder is 17. So write 17. Let's solve this. 65 into 5, 3, 1, 7, 5. That means 53,175. Let's multiply these two numbers into 65. First we are multiplied by 5. 5 is a 25 and 5 sevens are 35. That means 37. So 7 and 5 ones are 5, 8 and 5 threes are 15 and 5 fives are 25, 26. Next with 6. 6 fives are 30. 6 sevens are 42, that means 45, and 6 ones are 6, 6 plus 4 10, so write 0, and 6 threes are 18, 19, and 6 fives are 30, 31. So add these two numbers, 5, 7, 13, and 6, 15, 2, 3, 4, and 3. 3, 4, 5, 6, 3, 7, 5 plus 17. So add the 17. 3, 4, 5, 6, 3, 7, 5 and 17. 5 plus 7, 12. 7, 8, 9. 9, 3, 6, 5, 4, 3 is equal to 3, 4, 5, 6, 3, 9, 2. Is this equal to dividend? Yes, 3, 4, 5, 6, 3, 9, 2 and 3, 9. So we get the dividend, right? What is the dividend? 3, 4, 5, 6, 3, 9, 2. Is these two or equal? Yes. So the division process is correct. If the verification is right, is equal to the dividend, and we get the answer 2 are equal. If the 2 are equal, the division process is correct. So that means the division is correct. So this is the process of division. I hope you understand how to divide a numbers. Next I'll give you homework on this division. This is your today's homework on division. So note this homework and do this yourself and put it on WhatsApp. Definitely, regularly, I'll verify your homework. Okay, children, we will meet in the next class. Bye.